big.
Whatever.
Look, here's the key. Put it back in the same spot when I leave, okay?
All right. Well, for beginners, you're not begging. I don't mind sharing with you. And secondly, we got to change the spot of that key before I walk in and find that someone else has let themselves in.
Again? Lynch, what are you, their personal charity case?
I'm not their personal charity case. But if someone wants to bless you, my pastor says you should just receive it with an open and willing heart.
Okay, well, you can keep your open heart, but just do not with this ugly outfit in the opening, because it is ugly.
Very funny. Any calls?
No, now leave me alone because I was in the zone.
Hello? No, Minister Perry. Mom's not home. I'll tell her you called, though. We're doing just fine. Thank you for asking. Oh, yeah, and tell your wife thanks so much for all the food and gifts that she's been sending lately. All right, thank you. Bye-bye.
Sister Sarah sent this lemon pound cake for Mama. Is she here?
No. But wherever she is, I'm glad she went there because, you know, she hasn't left the house since the funeral 2 months ago.
Alexis, I'm sure you're over-exaggerating, as usual.
Nope, not this time. Your mama has been up in this house like an old hunter since the day they put your daddy in the ground.
Thank you for putting that so eloquently, Honda. Why are you always here?
Do not start in on Honda, Claudia.
Okay, because you know you can dish it, but don't want nobody to start in on you, because you know you can't take it.
Take what, Chevy?
Volkswagen? Whatever automobile you're supposed to be.
Oh, don't be coming up in here with your sour energy.
Sour breath?
Whatever, trying to mess up everybody's clothes, because I, for one, don't care what you say about me or my name.
Because H-O-N-D-A, Casanova.
I'm surprised you can spell the name.
Oh, boo, because I will go out up
there. Whatever.
Don't go over there, Mama. That's not crazy. Whatever.
Gotta go.
Shanice, I was telling you about.
She came up here the other day looking for you.
Why? Because she missed her maid?
Actually, she did mention the laundry.
Figure. No, I ain't seen her. I stayed at Danny's house last week. Since then, I've been staying at Shanice's. I'm thinking I just might stay.
How old are you? You have your own place?
No. Let's see. I live with my baby daddy, and after his wife found out about this one, she tried to kill him, then put him out. So he got a place to move me and my kids in.
How old did you say you were?
15.
Well, come on, Shanice, let's go get your baby.
Honda, can I talk to you for a minute?
Yeah. Look, take this to the car. Hold on. And look, I'm driving on the way back because you almost killed me over here, okay?
Yeah, what's up?
She real cool. You ought to see all her other kids. They are so pretty. And that baby right there, he gonna be real cute because he did white.
But honey, the girl's 15 years old, living with a married man who has a violent wife, on her fourth child with pink hair, and didn't you tell me she was selling drugs? I mean, honey, what are you thinking?
I'm thinking, I'm tired of being at home by myself every day, with mama running around with every man she meets.
Pretending to be saved on Sunday, singing in the choir, greeting people when they come to church, when she never greet me when she
do come home.
I'm thinking, I'm tired of playing dress up, pretending mama's the perfect mother in front of the pastor. I'm thinking Shanice is real cool, and I'm thinking I like her. I'm thinking every guy that I ever talked to just wanted to get in my panties. I'm thinking I want to start liking girls, and I think Shanice is a good place to start.
She is not gay. She pregnant, and she living with a married man. What are you even talking about?
She ain't even stunned Steve. She just using him for that place and using them kids for benefits. She already told me once she get his child support, it's going to be more than enough. More than enough for us to live off of.
I mean, but aren't you worried about God?
God? Like, what does God know about me? If God cared so much about me, he would have at least given me a mother and a father that would have stayed together long enough for me to get grown. If God cared so much about me, he would have at least given me a mother that knew I existed. But he couldn't do that now, could he? If you don't like me and Shanice's relationship, then we won't be back. Honda!
Whoa. That was deep.
What do you want? I am not in the mood today.
Don't take your friendship drama out on me. Is Mama here?
Do you see her?
And don't get smart with me either. I am still your big sister. Don't make me have to show you.
Don't make me have to show you.
I need to talk to Mama.
Well, she is not here. You want to talk to me?
You're too young to understand.
All right, if you're sure.
Jeff and I are getting a divorce.
I know. Mama told me. Are you okay?
No. I mean, I never meant for things to turn out this way.
Claudia, it's not your fault.
Alexis, the more I think about it, the more I think it's all my fault.
I mean,
Jeff is a good man, but I expected him to be daddy. Even though he did everything he was supposed to do, I just kept comparing him to Dad, complaining more than complimenting.
But Claudia still, that gave him no right to go out and cheat on you.
I mean, I know that, but maybe if I was showing him the love that he deserved,
He wouldn't have been going out looking for the affection that I wasn't giving him. I mean, now I realize that holding out on him was not the solution to our problems. He hurt me, but I hurt him too. I mean, Alexis, he paid all the bills. He cleaned the house, and I still felt like he was not doing enough.
Well, not every man is daddy, you know?
I know that now. Daddy was so perfect.
As far as we could see.
He never came home late. Mommy always, always had everything that she wanted. We never wanted for anything. He always had time for us. And we always had money. And when I married Jeff, that's all I knew. And that's what I expected. And after so many torn relationships with other men, my trust issues didn't help any.
How?
Well, growing up, I was always looking for a man that was going to make me feel the way that I thought Daddy made Mama feel. But it never worked out that way. I always ended up getting hurt. And now, I'm just thinking about, I got so tangled up in trying to find my father and my husband that my vision of what I wanted him to be clouded my view of what a good man he really was.
I mean, what do you mean? What are you trying to say?
Well, my trust issues with other men, basically, they caused me to not trust Jeff, even when I met him. You know, I just couldn't shake my trust issues. I was constantly calling him. I would pop up in the car and just follow him, or pop up at a business lunch.
Claudia, when you get married, don't they make you say for better or for worse? I think they make you say that for a reason.
Yeah, I figured that out the hard way. When Jeff lost his job, I almost lost my mind. And then we have the nerve to tell me to get a job. That's when I really lost it. But you know, looking back on it, I now think that I'm the reason he probably lost his job. I mean, he was more on the phone with me, telling me where he was, what he was doing, than being on the phone with his clients like he should have been. I just realized now that as much as I accused him of cheating, I probably pushed him into it.
You know, you had your problems in the marriage, and you had your faults, but he made the decision to go out and cheat on you all by himself. And that was his decision as a man. And that decision that he made was not right. And it gave him no right to take y'all's marriage the way he did, regardless of whatever he did.
You're right. I mean, he did make that decision. But what if he wasn't looking to cheat with that woman? I mean, what if he was just trying to get away from me and my nagging? I have to take ownership for the damage that I caused to the marriage, just like he does.
You're right, but still. You know, why can't he just sit you down, talk to you about it, or something like that, instead of going out pleasing some other woman?
Yeah. Alexis, you are wise beyond your years, but you are still just a child.
Y'all seen Honda? Not since Tuesday. Where she said she was going?
Looking for you.
Excuse me, I'm still your elder.
I can't tell.
Watch it.
Alexis, watch your mouth. Yvonne, what in the world are you wearing?
It's new, you like it?
No, get out my chair.
Look, you need to quit sitting around here. And I told you, you need to get back on the market. You need to let me take you shopping. You're too young to be sitting around here in hibernation. And you too, Claudia. Shoot, soon as that divorce is final, you come see me now. Let me get you back on the stroll. I mean, the crowd.
No thanks, Auntie. I'm good.
I done told y'all. Men are just like buses. If you miss the first one you're running after, just hold on,
because another one will come around sooner or later.
Yeah, and getting on the wrong bus
us will take you places you never meant to go while wasting your time and your money.
Yvonne, why don't you stop trying to reel everyone into your sin? You need to be worried about Honda. Do you even know where she's at?
Oh, that is why I came by here. Lex, where you say she was going?
Looking for you. But she did mean to
stop. Hold on, hush. Oh, yeah.
Hello. Hi, baby. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll be by there in just a little while.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Did you hear me?
Yes, I heard you. And if you say you saw her recently, I'm sure she's fine.
You are a horrible excuse for a mother.
Excuse me? You need to check that little girl you got running around here.
At least I know where that little girl is. You need to go out there and find yours and stop manhunting.
I'm not manhunting. I'm just being easy prank. I gotta go. Craig is waiting.
You need to look in the mirror on your way out.
Nice.
You need to take your own advice. And look, if y'all see Honda, tell her to come home because the lunch is piling up.
Mama, where have you been dressed like that?
I had an appointment. So have you and your husband made a decision yet?
I don't know. I mean, he said he's still going to file for a divorce next month, but he did agree to finish our counseling sessions.
Okay, sounds to me like the decision's been made then.
But I just can't stop hoping that maybe he'll give us another chance. I mean,
I know I drove him crazy, but
I apologize and I accepted his apology. It seems like he'd want to give us another chance and try again.
Claudia, maybe too much damage has been done.
I stuck by him when he lost his job, when we lost our house, and I even got a job and started really helping him out. I mean, now he just wants to go and abandon me. It's not fair.
Little girl, life is not always fair. Sometimes you just have to roll with the punches.
What are you talking about? Where's the encouraging mother that I used to have? Mommy, you did not die when Daddy did. Can't you just see past your grief for one moment and see that Alexis and I are hurting too? Mommy, I need your support. I cannot go through this divorce alone.
Claudia, listen. I'm dealing with my own issues right now, and all I have time for is my grief right now. You're an adult. Handle your own affairs.
Ain't nothing but prescription pills.
It's safe for both.
By hope.
She needs to be selling these bed at a higher dose than she's in there.
But my mama ain't bipolar.
So, why would she be taking these? And that phone call, it was from a doctor's office that I've never even heard of before, confirming mama's appointment for next Thursday.
Okay, what you say the name of the doctor's office was?
Dr. Adler's office?
Alright. Dr. Adler's office, 156 West 19th Street. It's listed on the heart doctor.
Heart doctor? I gotta find out what's really going on with mama.
There you go again, Lex, trying to run everybody like, your mama is grown. She can have her own business.
Clearly, I'm not trying to run everybody's life. Because, Honda, if I was, you would not be mixed up with that crazy girl. I'm telling you, I do not trust her.
Oh, kid.
No, I don't trust her. You know what? Surprised I'm even seeing you right now.
Oh.
She ain't let you out the house in a month.
Whatever, very funny. Shanice, she just gave birth to my beautiful baby girl, Destiny Ryan.
Oh, I miss my kids so much. I just wish y'all could get along long enough for you to come see my baby.
I really wish you would quit saying that.
Saying what?
It's so ridiculous you to call that child your baby. But I don't have time for this debate. You know, 156 is just a couple of blocks down, so I gotta go give her some answers. You wanna walk with me?
No, we're probably just supposed the whole way there. Call me if I'm gone when you get back.
All right.
Hey, Schnitz, baby. Mm-hmm. What you doing? I miss you too. What my baby doing? Oh, she hungry?
Honda, you seen Alexis?
Auntie, she
never mind. Look, when she gets here, just tell her not to bother me. I'm going to lie down.
Okay.
I promise you, I'll let you know that it's all yours.
Okay.
When? Well, how about tonight? Okay, see you then. Bye, baby.
Where have you been?
Hello, Rodney? Yeah, I know, but we only went on one date. And I don't know why he coming up in my house acting like that. I mean, I don't even know him like that. Well, look, okay, but I'm not even in town right now. And I'm trying to take care of something, so I'll talk to you about this later. I'll call you back later, okay? All right, bye. Now back to you. Where have you been?
Like you care.
Excuse me. I'm gonna ask you one more time. Where have you been?
Girl, you gonna make me.
Where have you been?
Man, go on. Why are you here anyway?
Looking for you. I came here looking for you. And you need to get home because the laundry is piling up.
Well, I guess you better get home and clean it because I'm done being your maid.
Look, you can call yourself my maid all you want to. All I know is you're my child, and I said get to the house right now, and that's exactly what I mean.
And I said I'm not going anywhere with you either. Man, you believe that daddy left your stupid behind? Walking up and down them in the mill talking about I can't work, my back hurt. On the phone with them sisters from the church talking about nothing. Mama, it don't take nobody 2 weeks to watch four loaves of
ain't my daughter. You can go out there and you can trick off too. You are not my mama. And then you sit up here and complain about how much I don't do at home. You aren't even there. Want me to pretend that you're the perfect mother in church? Well, you know you don't even care about me. But I see you don't have a problem walking up and down the street looking for a man with them shoes on.
Okay. Calm down.
Look, we have plenty of room here. She's welcome to stay here. She can just stay here, Vaughn.
She cannot stay here. I need her at home, and she's coming with me.
You need her home for what? To be your maid and message girl?
Oh, hush, little girl. Before I show you who is the real adult around here, since your mama won't.
Look, you're not going to talk to my child that way because you can't control your own.
Oh, say the dramatics, all right? So your husband dies. You run around here moping like some little lost puppy. Well, get over it. And you are a maid, and that's only because you choose to be one. And as far as you can go live with your father. See if I care. But you'll need me before I need you. Go, see what kind of man he really is. Since he got you thinking that I'm trash and all.
Whatever.
Honda, what are you doing? Where are you going?
I'm going to live with Shanique. And I know it may seem weird to you that I've fallen in love with a girl, but at least now you can see why.
Just because your mom is going through some things right now doesn't mean that she loves you any less. You know she still loves you. And Honda, you know what the word says about the lifestyle that you're living.
Auntie, I know what the word says about the lifestyle I'm living. Mama loves no one but herself. And I also know what the word says about mothers loving their daughter. Honda!
She'll come back, Alexis. She always does.
That's the thing. I don't think she will this time.
Shit!
She needs time to cool off.
I thought I was protecting you girls by not telling you my issues.
Mommy, in a way you are, but in a way you're not giving us a fair chance to be there for you.
It's just, you're going through your divorce and all your issues with Jeb, and Lex, although she acts mature, she's still only 15 years old, and I just didn't want to burden you girls with my issues.
But Mommy, that's what she wants you to understand. You're not burdening us.
Mama, I'm
sorry. I know, sweetheart. And I'm sorry, too. Sit down here. Girls, I promise I will let you in on more about what's going on with me. I want you two to know that I would never dream of leaving this earth without preparing you two girls first.
Mama, that's just what scares me. None of us know when our time ends.
She's gonna be alright. Don't worry about it, okay? She's gonna be just fine, I promise.
You can't promise that. I always thought Mama would be here, but look, she's gone. Just like that.
Hold up. I am so sorry about that, but
you do not have to worry about anything. I promise you can just stay right here with us. You don't have to worry about anything.
I don't think so, Lex. Now I gotta take care of myself.
But what about your father?
He stayed with me after Mom died, but while the family was packing and taking what they wanted, he helped. All that's left in the house is my bedroom suit and a refrigerator. He told me he would call when he got home. He never.
No, Hunter, please don't go. I mean, just please stay with me at least until tomorrow when Mama gets out of the hospital. I mean, Claudia has to go home tonight. Don't leave me here by myself.
Okay, I'll stay, but tonight will be my last night. I miss Shanice and the kids. They've been getting so big. Maybe I should let
succeed getting me pregnant so I can have someone to love forever.
Shanice, why? Look, I know I've been depressed over my mama's
destined out anyway. She was never there for me, but baby, I promise you, once I get it together, I'm gonna sell the house and...
No, Rhonda. We don't have a life together anymore. It's over. Steve says I have to choose between him, Rain, and you. And I gotta choose him.
But you don't even love him, Shanice.
And like Tina Turner once said, what's love got to do with it? Honda, I need him. He takes care of me and Rain. Not you. I don't see you paying no bills in the way we living in. And I ain't never seen or met a real man who's ever loved and cared for his own. I mean, since his wife is out of the picture, we plan on getting married and hopefully have another baby as soon as we can. Oh.
But you told me you don't even like having sex with him, Shanice. What about all that?
Well, I mean, it ain't so bad. I still don't like it. But Honda, he loves me. Especially he won't live without me. And no one has ever loved me like this besides my grandfather, and you know that. And when he passed, I thought I'd never feel this type of love again.
But Shanice, you know I love you like that.
But that's all you can do for me, Honda, is love me. But I need more than that in my life. I have 4 kids, and 3 of them don't even know who I am. Honda, look, my mind is made up, and I'm not risking losing my baby or my man over you.
I'll help you take care of her. Shanice, listen. We can get the other 3 if you want to, but just please don't leave me. I promise you, once I sell that house.
Once you sell that house, you need to invest in something for your future because you and I don't have a future together anymore.
Well, just let me talk to Steve.
Okay, first of all, I've already talked to Steve, and I'm making you put your hands on him. And he has made it perfectly clear that I can't have anything to do with you or any other female for that matter. I can have all the sex I want with him and his friends as long as he's in the room. Oh, honey, please, you best believe I'm taking that off. Best believe. But, like I said, he wasn't playing when he said no female. I'm sorry, honey. And look, I've changed all my numbers. Don't call my phone. And if you know what's best for you, you won't come by my house.
Janine, wait. I promise you, I'll kill myself if you leave me alone.
I love you so much.
I love you so much.
Could I ever y'all. Church is over, and right now, I really want to get my prayers on. Let's go.
She had to name him after all the guys she had. So she named him after Tyler, which was
that's his last name. And then Giorgio, it comes from his cousin name from like 5 years ago. He got killed in a car accident. But then Dorcel comes from the, you know, that Energizer Bunny, and it keep going and going and going and going. Just like the last. So she, that's how she came up with his name. Okay.
Wow. Meet us at the store, because we should be picking up Macy right now.
Well, I'm going to grab my purse, and I'll meet you girls outside.